Welcome, my name is Tim, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to diagnose an undercharged air conditioning system. Now, the undercharge could be just as a result of undercharging it during installation or possibly a refrigerant leak, which is a little more likely. Now, to begin with, we need to turn the thermostat to call for cooling. We're going to click on the selector switch, which will turn it to the cool position. This will also turn down the temperature setting of the thermostat, so it won't be necessary to use these arrows here. Now, after each step, we're going to refer to the procedure guide at the top so that we can move through this in a systematic way. So we're going to click OK, and our next step is to assess which electrical loads are operating, and this will allow us to determine whether we have an electrical malfunction or just a mechanical malfunction, such as a refrigerant charge issue or a possible airflow issue. So the indoor fan is operating, so we can click yes, and when we proceed to the outdoor unit, we can see that the outdoor fan is running, or the condenser fan. And we can tell that from the spinning blue arrows here. So we're going to click yes. Now, our compressor is also running, as evidenced by these spinning blue arrows. Now, if there's a lot of ambient noise or you can't tell, you can always attach a clamp-on ammeter to the common wire of the compressor and see that it's drawing current, and that'll verify whether it's running or not. So for now, we're going to say, yes, the compressor is running. Now, what this means is we have a mechanical problem. All electrical loads are operational. So our next step is to check refrigerant pressures as well as superheat and subcooling, and this will tell us which malfunction we have. Do we have an undercharge or a leak? Do we have an overcharge condition? Do we have a lack of airflow potentially outdoors with a dirty coil? Or do we have a dirty filter indoors? So we're going to start by attaching the red hose to the high pressure service connection at the liquid line, this glowing orange hotspot. And we're going to click OK in the procedure guide. And then we're going to attach our low side hose, the blue hose, to the service connection on the suction line here. And now we're going to take a look at the display on the gauges, and this will provide us with all the information we need. Well, if we take a look, right away we see that we have a 24 degree evaporating temperature based on 87 PSIG. Well, first of all, under no circumstances should an air conditioning system be operating with an evaporator temperature below freezing. That's an issue right there. So we know that pressure is unusually low. Our high side pressure is also low. If we look at the 86 degree condensing temperature when we converted the 253 PSIG, well, the condensing temperature should be about 20 degrees above the outdoor temperature, and it's much lower than that. The telltale sign here of whether it's a charge condition or an airflow condition is the superheat and subcooling. Now, depending on the type of meter and device, there are two different charging tables or indicators that are used. If you have a fixed bore meter and device, we use what we call target superheat. We measure the wet bulb in the indoor air as well as the dry bulb of the outdoor air, and there's a convenient chart that will give you the target superheat. In other words, what should the superheat be under these parameters? However, if you have a thermostatic expansion valve metering device, we can't use superheat because the TXV or the expansion valve maintains superheat. So we've got to use what they call target subcooling. And what this means is how much subcooling is actually taking place in the condenser. Now, the target can typically be found on the outdoor unit data plate. And if you look closely, you'll see it'll say TXV subcooling. And it may say, you know, 10 degrees, 11 degrees, 15 degrees. Well, this particular unit has a target subcooling of 13 degrees, and it does, in fact, have a TXV or a thermostatic expansion valve. So we should have 13 degrees of subcooling. You should have within plus or minus 3 of the target. So if we want 13, anything from 10 to 16 would be acceptable. But if we actually look at the subcooling margin here, we've only got 4 degrees of subcooling. That's way too low. And if we look at our superheat, 51 degrees of superheat indicates a starved evaporator coil, okay, meaning we're not putting enough refrigerant in the evaporator. It's boiling too soon. It's picking up a lot of superheat. This indicates that we have an undercharge condition. Now, listen, most undercharges are due to the result of a leak, and we're not going to address that here, but what I would tell you, now that we've determined we have an undercharge, you're going to need to do some leak detection. The first thing I would do is look for traces of oil around mechanical fittings, around your filter dryer, and at the fittings in the indoor and outdoor unit. You could run your finger around the fittings and see if there's any oil there. That would be evidence of a leak at that point. You can also use electronic leak detectors, which will pick up the presence of halide gases and locate the leak location for you, or at least get in the general area. But on a split air conditioner, because you're typically only going to have six mechanical joints, soap bubbles work just fine. Put a little soap bubbles on each joint and look for bubbling, indicating the presence of a leak. So we're going to assume we've done that and we haven't found any leaks, which most likely means that whoever installed the unit didn't charge the unit properly. So if we go to our procedure guide at the top, it's going to ask us, is the subcooling too high or too low? Well, our target level, again, 10 degrees plus or minus 3 degrees. So 13 down to 7 degrees would be acceptable in this case. We're obviously not within that range. We only have 4 degrees. So we're going to say it's low. Again, this means we do, in fact, have an undercharge condition. Now, you do want to pull the filter just to check it quickly. Not very difficult to do. Take the cover off the unit and just take the filter out of the box. You can zoom out and remove the filter and check it for cleanliness. We've removed the indoor cover, click OK. We're going to remove the filter. And if we take a look at the filter, we can see that the filter is very clean. There's no debris, no particulate matter on the filter. So we definitely have an undercharge condition here, which we kind of knew already. If the filter was dirty, our superheat would have been normal. And our superheat was really high, indicating a starved coil. So we click OK that we've pulled the filter. We've clicked no that the filter is definitely not dirty. And again, we want to go up and just inspect the return, make sure it's unobstructed. But because we had high superheat, again, it's not going to be an airflow problem. It's going to be a charge condition. The return is not blocked. Okay. Now, you can add refrigerant, but again, this is really important. Do not simply top off a unit. Always perform leak detection and repair any leaks prior to recharging the system. So we're just going to simply attach the gauge hoses again to the service ports. And when we do this, we're going to confirm no leaks exist. And we're going to turn this pink knob right here, which is tied into the refrigerant cylinder. And we're going to open the low side service port, and that's going to add refrigerant to the system until we obtain the proper subcooling margin, which we now have, 14 degrees. We're within 3 of our target. So we're going to click OK. And now we just want to confirm in the living space that we do, in fact, have cold air. You know, I would also watch one full cycle of operation and make sure everything's working properly. Good luck on all your future service calls, and I'll see you back here soon. Thanks for watching. Please take a second to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more great videos. You can try our on-demand VR-enabled learning for HVAC by signing up for a free trial. Go to interplaylearning.com to get started.